Come on. Our next song, Iro Ye, is a traditional African lullaby. We are honored to have Abby Hummel. She's a senior at Badger High School. She'll be graduating this year, very sad. But she's off to wonderful things, and she is playing with us.
Thank you.
Creed is singing for you tonight is Best Day of Our Life by... Oh, it's the best day of my life. It could be the best day of our life. It's my life. That just shows you how uncool I am that I don't know the name of it. I just need to direct them. That's all I need to do. Here we go with the best day of your life. We're going to sing a song called Jubilate. a song called Shularoon, and a song called Gone, Gone, Gone. And then the eighth graders will join us for a number. So, as you see, we have some gentlemen in the seventh grade choir, and we are working on training them how to sing the baritone part. So that is new for them. So they are doing a wonderful job, and I'm very proud of them. I'm proud of them.
Thank you.
graders are now joining us for our song Wild Mountain Time. We have a soloist at the beginning. Our soloist at the beginning is Grace Bornoff. She is a seventh grader.
Thank you.
Okay, as the seventh graders get seated and the eighth graders get situated in their normal format. I just want to say a few words about this eighth grade class. Are you ready? Because I'm excited. My seventh graders are telling me I'm not allowed to cry. Because I did at the Christmas concert. Who remembers? Yeah. Okay. Shh. I'm about to talk about it. It's not easy coming to a new school. It's really not. Sixth graders make it pretty easy because they haven't ever had anybody but me. Seventh graders, not so bad. This crowd behind me is a very tough crowd. We have spent many days talking about my expectations for them. And one of my biggest expectations for them is that they know how to read their music. Which they were not very happy about. I'm going to tell them a secret. So I have a philosophy, which this is really important, because it'll tell you, for those of you that have younger kids, like sixth graders, or even younger, that are coming up through me. I am a true believer in that band and choir kids should not be the only kids that know how to read music. Okay? Choir kids need to know how to read music too. It is essential to them being more than a singer, about being musicians. And my goal is to train well-rounded musicians and not just singers. So every time they do not have their music up, I will call them out to the guy. Take your music out. And he'll go, and he'll take it out. And then he'll hold it. I know I'm thinking of you, I'm sorry. And then he'll hold it. And none of the pages ever turned. It's not just Micaiah, though. I have sopranos to do it too, and I have altos that are just as guilty. Why? Because it's hard. Have you ever looked at a piece of choral music? In band or orchestra, you get just one little line, and the directors have to read the big things. You have to be able to hear all the other parts, but you don't get to see what everybody else is doing on the page. These guys have to look at not only their part, but their part, and her part. And in there, they have to figure out which line they're supposed to be looking at and which words they're supposed to be looking at. I'm not asking very much of them. Okay? So they know my philosophy is, think back to when you first learned how to read. In fact, you didn't even learn how to read first. You learned how to talk first. You learned how to talk before you learned how to spell. You learned to talk before you learned how to build a sentence and what a verb was and what an adverb was and present participles and things that I don't even remember. But when you first learned how to read, your teacher might have told you, Lucy, to use your finger. How many of you remember using your finger to help you read your music? I mean, read your books. Or have taught your kids to use their finger. I named him Fred. You can name him whatever you want or her. Shh. Okay? That finger really helps you follow that line. We highlight, we mark in pencil, we do anything and everything, and I harp on them day in and day out to look at your music. Because even if you don't know how to read it now, you'll never learn how to read it if you never look at it. Right? Look at all those parents nodding their head. They agree with me. Guess what? They're starting to agree with me too. only known these kids now since September, but I will not forget a single one of them. Okay, Frank. He said I'm supposed to miss him the most. I will miss them all. And the biggest reason why is because during solo ensemble, I really got to work with each one of them and get to know them. And they impressed me. They impressed me a lot with their hard work and their dedication to learn these songs, even though I was making them, because they didn't want to. Oh, maybe I should have told you that. But they did. And they all went on to perform at solo ensemble, which is not easy. You're standing in a room, singing a song in front of a judge, and he's listening to your voice. It's a very scary thing. Notice, they are all still alive. I have not lost one yet. Any one of these kids could go on in high school and be in choir, and I hope they do. And Mr. Raymer, any one of them would be great for you to have. Where's Mr. Raymer? Who's back there? So I just want to say how much I really appreciate this class. Thank you for sharing them with me. I will not forget them. We're going to sing in a minute, but I still have like three more things to do. And then I'll look, I've been really good about not talking. This concert is going to be way faster than the last one. I have awards. I had the students vote because while I've only known them for a year, they've been in choir with each other a lot longer. And we did three awards this year. We did most valuable choir member, most improved, and the best attitude. So that's the person who, no matter how cranky, Manion, I will put you by your side. Thank you, Ava.
Okay.
Shh. Best attitude is the one that no matter what kind of mood I'm in, they're, yes, Mrs. May, we can do it no matter what. Yep, we got this. Okay? And it was very interesting because they couldn't even pick one person. They picked two people for each award. And Mrs. Barrett and I looked at him and we agreed. We couldn't even decide between the ones that were picked. So I'm going to acknowledge those people now. They are. I'm going to start with best attitude. This person, seriously, has a smile on her face all the time. And is the first one to be like, what can I do? What can I do? Do you know something? What can I do? Hi, I'm here. And I love her for it. Jessica Spaniak. Over this year. And this really could have applied to a lot of these people. Because during solo and ensemble, when I got to hear them one-on-one, they really broke through some walls and were able to do some things that they didn't even think they could do, which is such a great thing to see. So our two recipients are
Julie. Thank you.
This is my favorite song ever.
Yes.
I just had to share. So I'm really excited we're singing it, and they like it too, and I hope they show you how much they like Bohemian Rhapsody.
Thank you.